Australia. There were several trial games between the nominated squad and Victoria, which I played. Couldn't play the next game with the flu. They flew me up to Sydney and I played for New South Wales against them. And then on the Sunday in Newcastle, I played for the Australian team. And then to get a letter in the mail to turn up at the Winter Village, gee, that's fantastic, because it was one of the first times that soccer had been accepted by all other sports. We were always way out there, we still are, if you like that. But being at the Village, you all are all meant to be the same. And I really didn't expect to play. So I played in all the warm-up games and played the two games. So that was the real highlight. The highlight since then is 74, obviously, because of fellas I played with a few years before. But to be in Germany in 2006, that Japan game was fantastic. And to see all the Aussies there singing was incredible.
I thought that goal you scored against Japan in Germany in 2006 was a crack of the ball. Can I just congratulate Andrew on the book? Thank you on behalf of us to Andrew, to Roy, and to George, who are keepers of the history of the game. It was just fantastic. But a lot of people in Australia think that the game here didn't start until 2004 when the A-League kicked off. So for all of us old folks, we thank you. My greatest highlight of playing with the Socceroo was actually Jimmy Tansey. Not only had hair, he also had an afro. And I've got some pictures for those of you that can prove that. Interestingly, I made my debut here in Melbourne against Greece, so the blue and white behind us is significant in the team with Duncan Cummings in it and George Christopoulos. There was no such thing as merchandise back in those days, so we ran onto the field. The Socceroos were booed onto the pitch by Melbourne's large Greek community. all in good faith, I have to say. There was a sea of blue and white. The only green and gold in the crowd was actually your grandma knitted someone a scarf. So they were very different days, but it was a great night. And I have to say, one of the proudest things I've ever done is stand on the field before you play and hear the national anthem play, and the hairs on the back of my neck stood up, and they still do today when I hear it. It's one of the proudest things I've ever done in my life. So, yeah,
that's good. Well, that was on the back of my head. Andrew, just very quickly, I did receive the book in the office today, and I just started reading it for 5 minutes, and half an hour later, I was still having a look, so congratulations and well done. Firstly, coming to Australia in the early 70s and watching the World Cup with players like Peter Wilson, Jimmy McKay, and Jimmy Rooney. And then 6 months later, being on a tour with them, Harry Williams, of course, was there. It was just amazing to see these guys and how they worked and how they gelled as a team. And Harry Williams actually got injured, and actually I made my home debut, if you like, against Russia at Olympic Park. It was a full house, and I don't think I've ever been so nervous, but as Gary said, when you're lining up and wearing the green and gold, and after 40 odd years, I'm still a passionate Australian and loving Melbourne. But lining up and hearing that national anthem against Russia was an amazing feeling, and something I still remember vividly, that's the way I'm looking for, and was very proud to do so, and it was an amazing feeling, so thank you.
Hello to everyone. Andrew, congratulations on the book. This is the first time I've met Andrew face to face, because over the years, being in the business of football, if we needed any stats, you rang Andrew or you emailed Andrew, and he had everything on you. So thanks for that. I desperately needed that for my website and, you know, for marketing my business. So I never knew that Andrew has gone to that much length to document so many things. And sitting here is an amazing experience. Obviously, in front of some of the older players who I got to see as a young player. Ted has always been around. You know, you see Ted here, but he's always at the forefront of the Socceroos. And congratulations to the older guys who are here. It's an honour to be in front of them. And as for my highlight, it was just an honour to make the national team. I think people don't realise the hard work that you have to, you know, put in over many, many, many years to get a chance to play for your country. And so, you know, I had four appearances. I scored a goal straight from the corner for my first game. It was a bit of a ridiculous game because Archie Thompson scored, I think, 13 goals against American Samoa, and he was lining up to score every minute of the game. I had the honour of playing in Japan in front of around 50,000 people, and that was a very nervous time for me. It was one of the biggest crowds I played in front, but it was a great game. We lost 3-0, but it was a great experience, and you know, something that you always hold as a memory. So thanks very much for inviting us today. It's an honour to be here.
Andrew, thanks very much, and everyone involved, Roy. I think like Gary and everyone's talked about saying how good the book was and is. And my experiences, first thing that comes to my mind, it's already been mentioned, is, you know, standing up for my national anthem. You know, that was the highlight of my career. Every game that I played was the national anthem. Playing for the Socceroos was a real journey, and I like to think it was a real education as well. It gave us an opportunity to travel around the world, see places like South America and going into Europe and Asia and Southeast Asia. And from a young age, it helped me understand how lucky we are to be in Australia and living in Australia. So the game not only apart from the passion of playing the game, but it taught me a lot of things outside the game as well. And I think the Socceroo journey from when it first started, and anyone who wore the Socceroo jersey, they're all united together now, and we support anyone who wears the Socceroo jersey. And fortunately, had the pleasure of going to Brazil and another Davidson.
For Australia, so that's good. That was a very proud moment for me as well. So, good highlights. Michael McKay, Marilyn McKay, we're in hostels. So, I'm the son of and wife of, or Marilyn's wife of, Jimmy McKay, who played for Australia. And thanks, Andrew, thanks for the invite as well. It's lovely to be up here with these legends. I suppose our highlights. I'm assuming your mum's highlight is carrying that. mine was getting a photo taken with him with a certain boot from on the back of the 1973 game. And probably there's a couple of highlights for us personally. We, not that long ago, 2013, made a trip to Sydney and Hong Kong with the team that represented Australia in 74, and that was pretty cool for us all to get back together again and do that trip. So we really appreciated that from the football family, but I also think more broadly for us, I mean, 1998, I think Dad passed away, and we've continued to be embraced by a footballing family since that time. So that's been kind of nice, including, you know, knowing many of these guys and the people from that team certainly. So